The finance department shares Swedish investors have expressed their strong interest in the Philippines, citing the country's robust macroeconomic fundamentals, improved business climate, and highly skilled workforce. A group led by a leading North European financial group, Skandinaviska and Skilda Banken, and the Swedish defense and security company Saab, met last week with Finance Secretary Ralph Rektor. The areas of interest include the Philippines' defense industry, drawing upon Sweden's track record in enhancing defense capabilities in countries like Brazil and Thailand. There's also interest in pharmaceuticals, financial solutions, green projects, and deeper public-private partnerships. Rektor, meanwhile, made a pitch for the country's flagship infrastructure projects, featuring 185 big-ticket infrastructure programs worth 9.14 trillion pesos under President Marcos's Build Better More program. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. bags at least $4 billion worth of investment deals as he wraps up his working visit to Germany. Among the investment pledges are a plan to develop an innovation think tank hub, as well as putting up data centers and solar cell manufacturing facilities. The Philippine president says he's looking forward to further strengthening the country's relationship with Germany, which he noted is one of the biggest economies in the European Union.
We are grateful for the interest of German companies to support the Philippines' commitment to sustainability and climate resiliency through the renewable energy investments that we received and were accounted as the top sector from Germany in 2023. I invite esteemed German business leaders to continue to keep in mind the Philippines as a reliable partner that can support your market expansion and your operations. We remain steadfast in our commitment to purposeful reforms, evident in key legislative amendments.
The two countries also agreeing to renew the cooperation program between the Technical Education and Skills Development Authority, or TESTA, and the Federal Institute for Vocational Education and Training in a bid to upskill and reskill Filipino workers.
Noting Germany's interest in expanded labor cooperation to include other Filipino skilled workers and professionals, the Philippines reaffirms our commitment to ensure the protection of the rights and welfare of Filipinos around the world. Both sides are also working towards the conclusion of the Memorandum of Agreement on the placement of skilled workers and other professionals.
After Germany, Marcos is set to fly to Prague for a two-day state visit. Meanwhile, the historic American trade and investment mission to the Philippines ending on a high note with high praise from the delegation for what it sees as Manila's business-friendly environment. Jackie Pascual tells us more.
U.S. Commerce Secretary Gina Raimondo ended the high-level presidential trade and investment mission thanking the Philippine government for a more welcoming business climate for American companies, though she did not mention the previous administration, which distanced itself from the U.S. Raimondo says she is happy with the developments under the Marcos Jr. administration.
President Marcos, it seems to me, is doing all the right things to make your country more business friendly, easier to do business in, and that's just music to our ears in the U.S. and to the delegation that I brought. I'm just really excited by what I'm seeing on the ground, and this is actually the very first ever presidential mission on behalf of the United States to the Philippines. So it's a historic mission in that respect.
She added that recent laws like the amended Public Services Act are also good measures to attract more foreign investments.
The message that we are hearing, the legislation that the Philippines has passed allowing for private sector ownership of infrastructure makes public-private partnerships easier. And it, I have to tell you, it sends a huge signal to the United States that the Philippines wants more investment.
Ayala Corporation Chairman Jaime Augusto Zobel de Ayala agrees, citing stronger Philippine-U.S. economic ties.
Your visit, Secretary Raimundo, also marks a significant shift in the direction that both the Philippine government and business sector have embarked on. In just the last 3 years, we've seen a rekindling of this relationship.
Various business groups met with Raimondo and said her visit signals renewed trust and confidence between the two nations.
Ease of doing business in the Philippines has improved. The legislation that's been passed has made it easier for foreign investors to come in and invest in almost any sector.
From an American Chamber standpoint, times are good. All the stars are aligned.
Raimondo also said the U.S. is now looking at more countries for the expansion of its semiconductor sector, which includes the Philippines.
The U.S. companies have realized that our chip supply chain is way too concentrated in just a few countries in the world. Forget about geopolitics, just at that level of concentration. You know, it's the old adage, don't put all your eggs in one basket. And that's the opportunity for the Philippines. Philippines already has 13 semiconductor assembly, testing, and packaging facilities. Let's double it.
22 American companies joined the high-level trade mission, including Microsoft, Google, Visa, MasterCard, FedEx, UPS, and United Airlines. Raimondo said the companies will invest a total of over $1 billion worth of investments, which include training and skills development programs. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine Clearinghouse Corporation advises the public starting May 1, all checks must conform to new standards to ensure security and uniformity. The Banco Central ng Pilipinas, meanwhile, clarified issues on dollar bills with markings. Alvin El Chico filed this report.
Businesswoman Christine Vasquez uses checks in paying suppliers and rent for her coffee shop venture. She says check payment is still preferred by clients compared to cold cash or digital cash.
Kailangan talaga yung check eh. Buti na lang nung nag-start kami, meron na kaming available na check. Before kasi nag-ano pa kami, nang hihiram pa kami sa parent namin.
Starting May 1, 2024, old format checks will no longer be accepted. The new check has a date format of month, day, year in Arabic numbers. There's a separate box for the check amount in numbers, as well as a separate box for signature.
Kailangan po yan. Kasi di ba marami na pong technological advances na mismo yung mga makina, pwede niya nang basahin yung signature mo, yung amount in figures, at saka yung date. Madali na po para sa teknohuliya.
For Christine, the new format is better.
Okay naman yung format niya. Parang mas specific po ano yung kailangan kong input, lalo na sa date. So, di ako nanibago nung ginagamit ko siya. Mas madali ko siya naintindihan.
The Philippine Clearinghouse Corporation advises the public to consult with their respective banks on what to do with their old checkbooks.
Kailangan nyo pong palitan na ng bago po yan. So pumunta po kayo sa banko para sabihin sa kanila na kailangan nyo na pong palitan yung mga check na yan dahil lumang format pa po, no? So, depende na po sa banko kung kailangan yung bayaran.
This early, government financial institutions like Pag-ibig Fund are not accepting old format checks already for contribution payment and investment. Meanwhile, the Banco Central ng Pilipinas has denied that U.S. dollars with stamps from money changers will only be accepted until March 12, 2024. Some consumers like Sarah do not mind if the U.S. dollars they purchase have some markings.
As long as it's authentic, I think, at saka as long as nagagamit naman yung pera, pwede na yun. Kasi ang importante naman yung purchasing power.
A money changer also said, while stamps do not make the currency fake, some clients prefer cleaner foreign bills.
Minsan may mga ano silang bansang pupuntahan, tulad sabi nila na Vietnam, ayaw nila na may tatak. So pinipili ko na yung walang tatak bibigay sa kanila. Then the other country naman, wala namang issue about sa tatak.
The stamps, according to Jul Kipli, is just used by money changers to indicate that the foreign currency passed through their system. Alvin El Chico, ABS-CBN News.
Travel platform Klook expecting strong tourism growth in the Philippines this year. Klook Philippines on Tuesday reported that travel bookings have tripled in the past year with a 21% increase in the average basket size. This led the app's revenue growing four times in 2023. For this year, Klook says 76% of Filipinos plan to travel abroad. And among the popular destinations, Hong Kong, Singapore, and Japan. Here at home, the app is betting on domestic tourism growth, with 92% of its survey respondents already having plans to travel across the country as early as now. The app also commits to playing a bigger and more active role in promoting Philippine tourism. The company is aiming to enhance its staycation offerings as well as develop domestic businesses to expand its merchant base and offerings by summer this year. COMELEC is holding a special satellite registration for senior citizens and PWDs in Quezon City. ABS-CBN's Victoria Tulad is there and she joins us for an update. Hi, Victoria. What do you have for us?
Hi, Michelle. Several senior citizens and persons with disability came here at the National Vocational Recreational Center in Escapa Village Project for Quezon City for the special satellite registration of the Commission on Elections, or COMELEC. Here, seniors and PWDs can register for the 2025 midterm elections. They can also update their information and avail of the Emergency Accessible Polling Place, or EAPP. Through the EAPP, voters are given a more accessible place, usually a room in the first floor of a school building, instead of going up the stairs to reach their precinct. COMELEC Chairman George Garcia said in his speech that it is their responsibility to make sure that they reach out to seniors, PWDs, those who are pregnant, and Indigenous people so that they are able to vote. There are currently 12 to 13 million seniors and 600,000 PWDs in the country, according to Garcia. He announced that in the May elections next year, early voting hours will be given to them, as well as other vulnerable sectors, which will be from 5 a.m. to 7 a.m. This way, they can avoid the crowd and the hot weather. Garcia also mentioned that new voting machines will be used in the next polls. According to some of the residents here at Project 4, this special satellite registration is a big help since it is nearer to their house and more convenient. They also said that it is important for them to participate in the elections since it is their duty as Filipino citizens. Aside from COMELEC, the National Commission of Senior Citizens is also present in this morning's event. Michelle?
Thank you very much for that update. Victoria Tula joining us on the line.